till it's worth more. Oh my God. It's so good to be back. You don't even understand. Like, you don't even understand how nice it is to be back with y'all. I've had laryngitis. You can still hear a bit of it. And you'll hear me drinking a bit more this show than usual. And we're gonna take it a little slower today. You ever get paid off of, I don't know, let's say your legs, your arms. Let's say you're a mailman, you walk or some shit. I'm a DJ, I get paid off my voice. When I lost that shit, I was fucking petrified, dude.
I know. You told me.
It kept going.
I was like, dude,
it kept going. It wouldn't stop. And I kept trying to get into places, and the crazy shit is like, I talk to people from Canada, they like the American healthcare system and shit, but like when you need shit done, you know what I mean? Like, I couldn't even get into a place. I'm like, yo, I got laryngitis, can I get in? Oh yeah, it's three weeks wait. I'm like, I'm a DJ. I need it for my job. Is there any cancellate? 3 week wait. I went to emergency. I went to motherfucking the
urgent care.
The urgent care. They kept trying to test me for fucking COVID. I'm like, I don't have fucking COVID.
Why did you get
the
test?
I got laryngitis. I've already had COVID. Well, they came out with new strands of COVID. Well, is that going to cure my fucking laryngitis? Because I can't talk right now, dog.
So difficult.
I just got up and left. I just got up and left. I took an Uber home. I was like, fuck this shit. This is ridiculous.
You're impossible.
And even urgent care, she's trying to push this fucking COVID test on me. I'm like, I'm not getting a COVID test, dude.
Why not? I had three last week. Who cares?
I tried to do the quick test. I was like, yeah, I'll do a quick test right now. Not accurate enough. Then why are we using them? If the COVID test isn't accurate, then why are we using them? doesn't... I was fine. After the first person was like, you need to get tested for COVID. I'm like, I don't have COVID. I have laryngitis. Maybe I could have both. It's quite possible I could have both. But to be real with you, I haven't been going anywhere. Try doing some shit with no fucking voice. People think that when you have an inkling of any sickness and you go out there and you try to do some shit, they think you're trying to kill them. I'm like, excuse me, can I get a... And people run away from me like I got fucking... like I got super AIDS.
Just might.
Like, yeah. So I've been in the crib chilling, man. Just fucking sitting there.
You sound much better today. A couple times when we spoke, you sounded really thrashed.
Dude, this is the first... Man, I'm doing everything, and I've done everything, because we went on the air. Remember when we went on the air, we took the call, the dude told me to do time. I did time, I did marshmallow, I did fucking ginger, honey, apple cider vinegar. I'm looking at, this is apple cider vinegar and honey I'm drinking on just to soothe my throat. I'm gargling with salt water. Finally, I started gargling with salt water and apple cider vinegar. And that seemed to start helping. And then I'm on fucking antibiotics. They finally put me on antibiotics. I'm like, couldn't we have done this fucking 2 weeks ago?
It's a process.
I'm laid up for fucking 2 weeks. All they had to do was give me some antibiotics.
Doctors must hate you. They must hate you.
They really must.
No, that's not what I mean.
They're like, are you going to take the test? I'm like, just give me the fucking antibiotics. Yeah, not going to be able to do that. I should have been, if I take the test, will you give me the antibiotics? I should have asked them that just to see where their head was. You know what I'm saying? Like,
you got to play along.
Dude, I'm not playing their bullshit ass game. The lady was like, oh, you know, you might get someone sick. I'm like, I don't go. Have you noticed they closed the whole fucking state down? You fucking moron. Have you noticed that? Where am I going to go? Who am I going to get sick? I can't go anywhere.
And you never turn it off. Ugh.
Yeah, that's how I live. I keep it real. I keep it 100 all the fucking time.
Seriously.
Honestly, it's my life. I'm just looking at this fucking nurse like, are you going to fucking help me? Like, let's say I did have COVID. Give me the fucking shit for the fucking laryngitis regardless. It doesn't fucking matter. You know what they, you know the shit that they use to treat your laryngitis. Give it to me.
Well, whatever you're doing now seems to be working.
I'm on antibiotics. I'm drinking. Yo, I chopped up, stunk up the crib, man. I drank onion juice. It's like just onions. You boil down onions until it's like a weird jelly. I'm drinking onion jelly. I'm drinking fucking, I didn't know marshmallow came from an actual fucking thing that grew out of the ground, but I was drinking marshmallow shit. It coats your throat. It's fucking crazy. And finally, I'm like, look, dude, I tried it. Just give me the goddamn pills, please. And here I am talking to y'all. And this whole time, I'm like, y'all got to understand that, like, I'm from a place where, like, I was broke. Like, I grew up poor. So, like, I'm like, shit, man, I need this fucking, like, I haven't been to work for 2 weeks, man. I was fucking freaking out. Like, what the fuck? And we all know people as serious that have slacked off more than that and kept their job longer. But, like, that's not how my brain works. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, nah, bro. Like, I need to be on the air. But I couldn't even. Today was the first day where I can actually talk. Yesterday I could talk a bit. But I wanted to hold off to where I could have a conversation. 888-742-3345. How y'all doing out there? It's Friday. It's Feel Good Friday. I feel good that I'm on the fucking mend. I'm telling you, man. You really appreciate your health when they take shit away from you.
Oh, no question. By the way, Jake in Fort Worth, Texas, he's got some ideas for your voice. Keep
Jake,
on the right
go
track.
Ahead.
Jude, here's what you got to do, my man. You got to get you a shot of tequila, but pour some salt in it. Pour salt in the tequila, and then when you take it, kind of let it sit in the back of your throat. Don't just, like, throw it back like it tastes bad. You got to let it sit there for a little minute and kind of, like, swallow it real slowly. Then after that, probably want to chill for a little minute, but right after, you want to get you some whiskey with, like, some hot tea, whatever kind of tea you want, just like a hot tea, and put some honey in it. Put about a shot of whiskey, just like
that's lit.
Yeah, yeah, exactly, a hot toddy, but not a lot of tea though. Like equal parts, one shot of whiskey.
I gotta go.
Sounds like he's got an alcohol thing going on.
And then another thing you do, you take a tampon, you dip the tampon in
vodka,
in some vodka, and you shove it up your ass, and that's gonna make the pain go away. Whatever's going on in your throat, you're not gonna think about that. That's the third thing you do. So you do the tequila with the salt real slow. You do a hot toddy, then you shove vodka up your ass. Hey, today, 742-3345. It's been a minute. I appreciate y'all. Now, I actually, you might have been being dicks. I haven't been on my Instagram. I ain't been doing shit. All I've been doing is watching poker shows over and over and over again. We got anybody worth talking to?
John Z out of Connecticut doesn't appear to be an alcoholic.
John Z, what up, man?
Yo, man, fuck that. I don't drink. I smoke a lot of weed, though.
All right.
Jude, listen, man, you got laryngitis. That's bacterial. You don't want any sugar.
Okay.
So no motherfucking sugar, and you need some Jamaican rum, man. You need some brand after you.
Jamaican rum's made out of sugar.
Yeah, it's, but the sugar's gone. It's just alcohol at that point.
What do you
There's
think
no
alcohol
sugar in it, dude.
Is?
The fucking,
all right, bro.
It
I gotta
gets converted
go.
Into alcohol.
I gotta go. This fucking guy. I get it. It's bacteria. You don't need sugar. That's why I was doing the salt with the fucking... the apple cider vinegar and the sea salt. That shit... that gargling fucking really came in. That makes... that... the 1-2 punch with that and the motherfucking... And the antibiotics... and it just being 2 weeks. So for all I know, this shit could have been going away regardless, but fuck.
We've got Al in Detroit.
Is Al a doctor too? Al, what's up?
What's good? You know, I ain't exactly a doctor or nothing, but I know what you're going through, bro. I had laryngitis and I had me a cold before. You need to keep doing what you're doing and rest your voice. Gargle the salt water. Take you some elderberry to get that cold out of your system.
I'm doing all of that. I got the elderberry syrup. I got gummies. I'm doing all that shit. Yeah, I'll be surprised. Yeah, like, and rest my voice. I really haven't said shit for 2 fucking weeks. I'm like a monk. You know when the monks go to them places and they don't say shit? That's me. I ain't even jerk off. I'm literally a monk. I'm a fucking monk.
For 2 weeks, you haven't done that?
Bro, I just been so sad. This laryngitis made me so sad. I didn't want to jerk off, bro. Like, I just was just... I didn't realize how much I enjoyed my job and how much I appreciated talking to people and shit like that, you know? Shit's crazy. When they take that shit, when it's taken away from you, whether I did it or not, I don't know how the fuck it happened, but like when it's gone, you're like, what the fuck? Eight is 8-7-4-2-3-3-4-5. We're gonna do confessions for a little bit. I'm a minister. I'm more of a minister than you guys are doctors, I'll tell you that much. I'm a fucking minister, and if you have anything on your heart that you need forgiving, I, as an ordained minister, can help with this forgiveness so you can ultimately forgive yourself and move forward in life. 888-742-3345. 888-74. Put on the Tibetan monk shit. Put it on.
That's coming.
Put it on, John.
Why? We've got...
put it on.
It's hiding in a corner of the world
John,
here.
Put it on.
It's coming.
On the monk shit.
It's coming.
John, I'm a minister. Put it on.
And we're going to...
what's wrong with you, man?
We're going to heal the world.
It's almost like he doesn't respect the fact that I'm a minister and won't put on my monk music.
You're with the Universal Life Church? Is that it?
Yeah. You got a problem with that?
No.
You don't like the universe or life?
That makes us brothers in the cloth. Yeah.
I'm a preacher too, and I'm an imam. So, and I'm a rabbi. I'm all of that shit. I'm universal. Give me the fucking music, John. Oh my God. You're fucking killing me.
You wouldn't believe how this is supposed to happen, and now I've got a
bit. It's not happening.
It'll happen in a second, but
all right, John, you're just gonna have to hum in the background like a monk.
I will
do it. No, for real, just do it. Oh, all right, all right. Do it. Are you doing it? All right. What's up, y'all? My name is Jude Angelini, and I'm a minister. You're not humming, John. That's Like a fucking monk, like you mean it.
I'm a no.
Faggot ass monk. You sound like a bitch made monk. All right. If you got any problems that you, any, if you did any sins, if you sinned at all in your eyes and you need forgiveness, you call up right now. 888-742-3345. You found it?
Oh, I just developed some real skill. There we go.
Do you feel like you sounded like them?
It's on the way. These guys are a little more intense.
You was just like humming it on. These guys are they on some real religious shit. Turn this shit up. Have you sinned and you need to confess your sins? Call up right now. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. It is an all-out show. It's Confessions with Judy. Don't go anywhere. I got you. Let's go.
You're listening to the all-out show with you.
I'm here to forgive your sins. Have you been sinning since I've been gone? I've been gone for 2 weeks. So I know you've been fucking up. You need some forgiveness in your life. And me being a minister, I can give you this forgiveness. Three, three, four, five. I'm here for you. You have to reach out, though, for your forgiveness. 888-742-3345. Any sin. The worse, the better. The more forgiveness you need, the better. 888-742-3345. What we got, John?
Got Phil in Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Phil, what would you like forgiveness for?
So for the last 2 years, Jude, I've been cheating on my wife and going to massages, but they're all happy endings. Haven't been connecting with my wife and cheating on her constantly with these Asian massage therapists.
What kind of Asian?
All of them. Pretty much anything. You don't really pick them. You just walk in and the bottom of the barrel,
Thai.
It is what it is.
I usually end up with Thai or like some Chinese wizard.
Oh, it's these are mostly fucking Chinese.
Yeah. That's why I was asking. Depends on where you're at. You're in Wisconsin. Look.
Yeah.
If you're going to cheat, this is like the best kind of cheating. Hand jobs.
Mm-hmm.
It's the best kind of cheating.
Yeah.
That could be real.
I mean, I feel bad, but.
Let's take a deep, why aren't you connecting with your wife? You're forgiven for the hand jobs.
She's miserable when she comes home from work.
What's that?
She's miserable when she comes home from work. And, you know,
what does she do?
It's easy to do. She's in the medical field.
Huh. You need her money to float?
I do.
Or can you, so you need to be making more money.
Yeah.
Why aren't you making more money? What are you doing? What do you do?
I work as a plumber, but you know, she makes about twice what I make.
You're a plumber? People are always looking for fucking plumbers.
I know, but when you're in the medical field, I guess you make more money. And I'm just burning
like
on
a doctor or some shit?
Yeah.
Oh, she's a doctor? Damn, a doctor and a plumber. That's dope. You need to sit her ass down and be like, look, we are not connecting. You seem like you're miserable at your job. What do you want to do? And go from there. You're forgiven for the rub and tug, okay? It's not that big of a deal.
Appreciate it.
That is the most lightweight cheating possible. Rub and tugs. In some countries, they don't even count it as cheating. That's how lightweight it is. It's really just a dick massage.
It is.
And if you ask me, I think all massages should end with me ejaculating. Because that's the ultimate.
Sometimes it's more, but it depends on what you pay.
All right, so sometimes you're getting some head or some shit like that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, all right. So now it's coming out. ixnay on the ed, hey. You can't be getting head from these Chinese ladies, okay? Alright? And fucking holler at your wife and talk to her.
I appreciate
see
it.
See what she wants to do. You are forgiven. Move. And congratulations on bagging a doctor. And congratulations on having a plumbing job. And maybe you should hustle a little bit harder in your plumbing job. Or maybe you should go on your own so you can make more money. I need to get a fucking plumber. You know what I mean? Like, there's so much work for these fucking people. For him to be like, we're not making enough money is, it's baffling to me. There's so much work for people that actually know how to work with their hands, because none of us know how to do that shit anymore. What else?
Jack in Connecticut.
Hello, Jack.
Yeah, it was good, Jude. Yeah,
you got
it.
What do you want to confess?
I fucked a $40 hooker that smelled, and I ate her pussy too.
Oh. You fucked a $40 hooker? What'd she smell like?
Just like she just been having sex all day. She just ain't take a shower for like 3 days.
She smelled like a bunch of other dudes' nut and shit like that?
Pretty much. Like, she got in a truck, and I was just like, oof, this is gonna be rough. Real rough.
she was a lot lizard?
Nah, she wasn't a lot lizard. I just drive a truck, but she wasn't a lot lizard.
I'm just curious. I'm trying to get the full. All right, look, man. You don't bargain hunt for sex workers. You deserve better than that. Okay?
Yeah.
You are forgiven for having such low standards that you're fucking $40 horse. I want you fucking $100 and up, okay?
Oh, of course. No, definitely.
Yeah. You're too good for $40 hookers, all right?
Oh, of course.
Of course, because you're calling me, telling me that you fucked a $40 whore that smelled like everybody else's cum. So, not of course.
Yeah. I was horny, though. Yeah.
But am I horny enough to fuck a $40 whore? You can go to restaurants and you can't even get like a meal for fucking $40, and you're fucking the whores for $40?
Well, she originally wanted $35, but it was, you know, I threw an extra $5 because I felt a little pity, so I was like, here's an extra $5.
You threw an extra $5? Like you're a fucking, like you're fucking Daddy Warbucks, the fucking, being all fucking giving and shit. Like, here you go. Here's that. Here's a little extra $5. You deserve it. Congratulations.
The thing is, I make enough that I could afford, you know, high dollar hookers. But
I understand that sometimes there's something in us that likes to do disgusting things. I'm that guy too. You are forgiven for that, but you're forgiven for liking to degrade yourself, because that's basically what it is. You degraded yourself. She was she'd been degraded. You degraded yourself. You're forgiven for degrading yourself.
Appreciate it, dude. Thank you.
And you're probably gonna.
Whoa, where'd you go?
I'm right here, John. Okay. What are you talking about?
Well, you're moving around and your voice disappears. There we go.
What do you want me to tell you?
Don't move so much.
I'm doing the best I can.
Okay.
With what I have. 888, including you. 888. 742-3345. I am a minute. You want me to talk to John?
There we go. Well, I lost your audio again. You're moving around too much. There's something going on.
John, I'm not moving around. Something's going on over there. Like, I haven't. Right. You see me on the fucking thing. I'm going.
It's like you're folding laundry off to your right or whatever's going on. Right.
I don't know.
All right, so
the light's over there. I'm trying to make it so you can see me.
Okay,
but I guess you hearing me is better.
All right, I've got Is Donna also out of Detroit.
It's Donna. What up, though?
What up?
You got it. What's your problem? Or I mean, what would you like to confess? This is confessions.
I stole a speaker when I was 12, and I'm feeling real bad about it.
You stole a sneaker or speaker?
Speaker.
Are you old like me? Was it out of the back of someone's truck or some shit like that?
No, it was out of a house party. I stole a speaker out of the house.
You stole someone's speaker out of their house?
Yeah.
God, that's some asshole shit. What'd you do with it?
Yeah, I
know. Nothing. You didn't do a fucking thing.
I gave it away.
Did you?
Oh.
I'd be so mad if I came back and one of my speakers was, as an audiophile,
yeah,
I'm fucking
mad at me.
They deserve to be. As an audiophile, I'm more upset about this than the other two dudes. You're forgiven for fucking stealing the speaker. Have you made amends?
I have, but I need forgiveness for this.
You're forgiven. I just want to know what did you do to make things right with the person you stole the speaker from?
I didn't do anything yet to make it right.
Do they even know that you stole the speaker?
They know I stole it, yeah. But they never see me again.
Alright, so this is what you're gonna do. Can you find them?
I can't.
Oh.
They're far away.
Alright, then look, bro. You did the best you could. You feel bad. It's eating you up inside. I forgave you. Move forward. I'm sure they have. They probably keep a close eye on their speakers. Now.
Yeah.
At house parties. Okay. All right. Bye. Motherfucker stole one speaker. You know, then you have to listen to everything through mono. You got to put it on mono, or else you're only going to get the left speaker. What a dick. What a fucking dick.
He's 12. I didn't know.
As a speaker, as like a fucking, as an audiophile. All right, go ahead.
Jay in Houston,
what do you need forgiveness for?
All right, Jude. Me and my girlfriend and her friend had a threesome, mm-hmm. and they both were drinking. Both got passed out, and while they were asleep, I kind of finished up the job just on her friend.
So while they were sleeping, you... On her friend?
Yeah, pretty much. Don't feel kind of bad about it, but after, you know, next morning woke up and stuff like that, we went again, and... That was pretty much it, you know, but I just feel kind of bad, you know, because, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's some asshole shit to do. It's like a cunt hair away from, like, sexual assault, but I feel like since you already, like, we're doing it, you know what I mean? Like, it's not as bad, but...
I mean, the morning we went again, you know... So,
all right, so yeah, so clearly. Did she know that you had came on her when she was knocked out?
I don't think so.
You did? Oh, you did that? That escaped? That is that you forgot to tell her about that part? Like, hey, by the way, when you were knocked out, I fucking came. Where did you come?
On her stomach.
All right. So she was sleeping, and were you fucking her when she was asleep, or did you just fuck?
Yeah, she was drunk, passed out.
Dick was in her, or did you put your dick in her after she passed out?
Oh, after she passed out.
So that's kind of rape.
Well, I mean, we're fucking before, even next morning.
I get it. I know, but like sometimes when people knock out, you got to be like, okay, that's it. But then there's been other times where I'm fucking a chick and I fuck her to sleep. And now I'm like, all right, I'll just kind of chill there for a second. And it's, I don't know how you enjoyed it. It gets boring. I'm like, this is fucking boring. I don't know what the fuck Bill Cosby saw in this shit, because this is boring as hell.
Yeah, I mean, I had consent before and after, I guess. And it's kind of like, you know, your girl say, hey, wake me up with sex and shit like that.
Yeah, but it wasn't your girl, and she was knocked out. you're forgiven. It's a touch rapey. It's not like fucking no, don't do it back alley like shit. But area. Like it's a touch rapey. But you're forgiven.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I don't know how the court would see it. It depends on what you were running for and who you were running against. Or if you're about to host the Oscars or some shit like that. Don't apologize ever. None of that shit. They'll come get you. They'll cancel your ass. Alright. Give me something else. I can't end with this fucking... I can't end with that guy. I can't end with... Why are you looking at me like that? Did you hang up on everybody?
No, we're good.
Alright, give me somebody else. I can't end with fucking this dude... like... fucking a passed out chick in the middle of a threesome.
We've got Junica in Jacksonville, Florida.
Junica, what up? What up? You got it, man.
I like them fucking weirdos, man. Mine is a simple forgiveness, man. I've just been on a tangent with these broads, though.
You don't need to be forgiven for that. Why you need to be forgiven for that?
I mean, dog, man. 5 bitches in a week, my dude. I wake up feeling guilty.
You just bragging. You just bragging on your dick. You're forgiven for bragging on your dick. How's that? You are forgiven for calling up to brag on your dick. One more, John. Let's try this again.
Derek in Canada.
Derek, what would you like to be forgiven for?
Oh, I stole money from a developmentally handicapped person.
Like how developmentally handicapped? Like Rain Man or like fucking Welcome Home Jelly Bean?
Like Welcome Home Jelly Bean, you know, like right out to lunch. So I was bartending and was running this like NFL pool and everyone was getting this guy like, hey, you should, you know, put in $10. You'll win. So this guy won. I had to tell him, like, dude, you won. He's like, won what? Like, he had no idea. So the pot was like $700 and I took it. Told him he won.
Oh, you're a dick. You're a piece of shit.
I know.
What a fucking asshole.
And I was, you know, I was like this young bartender, just nosediving every night, you know, I wasn't thinking, but bumped into the guy a couple years later and basically emptied my pockets, told him what I did, and he still had no idea, but, you know, I still feel like a piece of shit, but
you're a piece of shit.
I could do. I gave him, yep.
You're a piece of shit. All right. You try to make it up to him. You know that that's a shitty thing to do. We do not fucking steal from fucking developmentally disabled people. Whatever. I hate that they took retard away from me, and I don't even know. They didn't give me another word.
Was it differently abled or something?
What the fuck? Everybody's differently abled. We're all differently abled.
Yeah.
All right, you're forgiven for fucking stealing from this fucking dude that was clearly a cunt hair away from being like, you know, fucking quirky or whatever the fuck. Down syndrome. You're forgiven for that, but that's some asshole shit, dude. Real asshole shit, and I'm glad that you saw the error in your ways and that you tried to move forward past it and that you tried to give back the money. And that shows you how fucking how gone he was. He didn't even know. What a piece of shit you are. You're forgiven for being a piece of shit. We've all been pieces of shit in our life, and we all need to forgive ourselves. You are forgiven. All right. Coming up next, it is Feel Good Friday. Don't go anywhere, y'all. That was Confessions.
Yeah. You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Ah, I feel good.
Make me feel good. Just make me feel good.
Feel good. Move that you're by my side.
Oh, yeah.
It's Feel Good Friday on the All Out Show. Tell us what you feel good about. 888-J-45.
I am left. And now it's just me, John Keenan, and we got Shanice out of Philly helping us out. You need to take time out to think about what you're grateful for. It's so easy to get caught up in shit that bums us out or pisses us off, or you look around and people are telling you to be upset about this or be mad about that, and you don't even see it. That's the crazy shit. And what I want you to do is stop and think about what you're grateful for in your life. I want you to stop and think about what you're happy about in your life, what you're looking forward to in your life, all right? And that's how we stay happy. And you need to be grateful. We all do. From the top to the bottom. And what am I grateful for? I'm grateful I get to come back to work. I was going crazy. It was almost 2 weeks. What was it, John? Almost 2 weeks?
Yeah, if you'd been out till Monday, it would have been 2 weeks.
Fucking nuts. I was a fucking cunt hair away from being gone for 2 fucking weeks. Because I had laryngitis, I couldn't talk. I'm grateful that I can talk. I'm grateful that I can work. I'm grateful that I have a job that I can go to. So these are the things that I'm happy about. Please make yours fucking more interesting than mine. Mine's not that interesting, let's be real. But for me, it meant a lot. Like, it really gave me some perspective. And I'm so happy that I can actually just fucking have a job, be able to talk. I think I'm gonna leave the house for the first time and get I need to get a high pressure shower head. If you know a good one on Amazon, send the link to John. Like that? DM at John Z Matthews with an Amazon link for a fucking super high power shower head. Cause I got that. If the world ends, I got the drinkable water. I got the drinkable water, and I got a gun so you can't take my drinkable water. But I gotta tell you, the shower head situation,
low flow.
It's like getting pissed on by a fucking toddler when I want to take a fucking shower. It's like getting peed on. I'm like, this is not doing it. Maybe when the world ends, I'll be fucking stoked about it. But right now, the world hasn't ended yet, and I just want a high power shower head. Anyway. But I'm grateful that I have my own well. See, look at that. You can still find things to be grateful for. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. Call up right now. It is Feel Good Friday. What are you feeling good for? Who we got?
We've got Mark out of Virginia.
Mark, what up, though?
What up, Judy?
You got it. What are you feeling good
man,
for?
Man, I'm sitting in the line at the pharmacy fixing to pick up these perks, and I'm going to get fucking faded.
Nice. Be up in that bitch itching. I ain't going to bullshit you. There was a couple nights where I was bored as fuck, and I just started eating Vicodins. I'm like, this is making this show way better to watch.
Fuck yeah.
It was making them YouTube videos way more entertaining. I'm like, this is okay. I can deal with being fucking laid up.
This is my plan.
What is
it? I'm gonna get as many of these motherfuckers in me as I can. I'm gonna take some Saran wrap and some Vaseline. Boy, we're gonna have a good time.
What the fuck does that mean? Saran wrap and Vaseline?
Yeah, man. You put Vaseline on your dick and wrap that Saran wrap around that motherfucker real good.
Yeah,
and it's on.
Then what do? You jerk off with it?
Visualize? Yeah, what? Man.
Wow.
Makes it tight.
Yeah.
Nah, I'm just fucking with you.
No, you're not. No take backs. No take backs. So it's fun to put, take some saran wrap and put some Vaseline.
Never heard that.
RIP to Big Ange. He actually did some shit like that. Not to his dick. He saw this movie called Runaway Train with John Voight and Eric Roberts. And they put grease all over themselves and then wrapped themselves in saran wrap to keep their body heat in them. And we went around, we was washing windows. He put Vaseline and shit all over his hands and then put his gloves on. And they're like wool gloves. And he would take off his gloves and touch the fucking people, like touch the women. He would shake their hands. And I'd be like, bro, you can't do that. Your hands are all fucking slimy and hairy. We need to keep our job. He's like, what the fuck are you talking about? It's keeping me warm. No one cares. I'm like, Ange. I'm looking at his hand. He's got like mad fucking wolf fuzz coming off and they're glistening and shit. I'm like, no, dude, you can't do that, man. Stop. And he get us fired. He didn't. RIP to Big Ange. And shout out to Saran Wrap and Vaseline. Let's go. What else we got?
Bradley in Ohio.
Yo, Bradley.
Hey, hey.
What up, though? What are you feeling good for?
Just bought my first house, moved in over the weekend, taking my last load there now.
Congratulations, man. You got a kid, a girl, and are you starting with the house?
Just me and the fiance. We nice. Plan on adopting sometime this year.
Your dick doesn't work, or you just want a throwaway kid?
Throwaway kid. the dick works.
Good for you. Steve Jobs was a throwaway kid, so there you go. You can't shed on all throwaway children. But, God damn it, man, if your dick works, why not make one of your own? There's so many out there.
My girl can't have kids.
Oh.
Girl can't have kids, so the best therefore we can do adopting. Is we can adopt and
there you go.
We can help out a child who needs it.
Good for you. Get one that looks like you or else they're going to look at you all crazy like they did Angelina Jolie.
Right?
Yeah. I don't know what color you are, but yeah. Try to make a match or else they're going to give you looks. Yeah, that's coming from someone that. Else. Yep. My daughter's mixed. People think, and I was a teenage father, so people would look at me like I was like the biggest scumbag ever, walking around with this like young mixed girl, thinking that I was dating her. I'm like, nah, motherfucker, I'm her dad, you fucking asshole. 8-8-7-4-2-3-3-4-5.
Chelsea in Utah.
Chelsea, Utah.
Chelsea, what's up, Ridgey? What's up, baby?
You got it, girl. What are you feeling good about?
I'm feeling good because I'm off work. It's Friday, and I got some good dick waiting at home for me.
You got some good dick waiting at home for you at the crib? What you finna do to that
hell
dick?
Tell, yeah. Tell,
what are you gonna do to that dick?
Everything.
What does that mean?
All the damn things.
You gonna put it in your mouth?
I know how nasty you are.
You gonna put it in,
all
you gonna
up
put
in
your
and
mouth?
Around it.
Yeah? You put it in your vagina?
Yes, sir.
You put it in your butt?
Oh, my goodness.
That's where it ended right there. Yeah.
We can do a little booty play.
Look at you. You got mouth, you got all three holes. I don't know of any other holes he can throw it in inside of you. Congratulations.
All holes, whole weekend.
All holes, whole weekend. Fucking do it in.
Yes,
catching up for me. Catching up for the fucking show. Yeah. You don't have to tell anybody. It'll be your own little nut. Just be like, oh, all out show.
Oh, God.
Oh, good nut, all out show, yeah. John.
Oh, my
chin.
Goodness. Just talking to you. I love it. Thank you so much.
All right. Take care. Shay 45, what are you feeling good about? It's Feel Good Friday.
Eric in New Hampshire.
Eric.
Thanks for having me on, guys. I'm grateful for after 10 years working for Volkswagen and Audi, I just got hired at Porsche.
Look at you moving on up all the German shits. All the, you went from the Nazis to swing. I don't know. Was Porsche down with the Nazis too? They probably were.
They're all not. Well, actually, Audi's not a Nazi, but yeah, Porsche is Nazis. Porsche is Frederick, whatever the heck his name is, Frederick Porsche, who made Volkswagen, but that was because Hitler made him make Volkswagens.
Yeah, yeah. People, everybody's like, oh, Porsches, Volkswagens, Nazis, Hugo Boss, Nazis. I was like, you gonna tell Hitler no? You gonna tell that motherfucker no? You see what the fuck he does to people? He says you say no to. You ain't gonna do shit, but you ain't gonna do shit. But shut the fuck up and sew him a goddamn shirt like he told you to, bitch. So have fun.
Damn right. Thank you for having me on. Appreciate it.
Congrats. And what are you gonna be doing for Porsche?
I'm gonna be selling car parts, diagnosing vehicles, basically making money off of people who are. You know, they don't got nothing to do during these times, so they're just buying cars and racing, I guess. Making race cars.
Yeah, car values are going crazy. Like, cars are selling for more than what they're worth right now. It's fucking nuts.
Yeah, it's a big swing in the automotive industry. They expected the used cars to go down, but the problem is you can't import anything too much now. So all the used cars that are trapped in the country, they're going up.
Are you getting any discounts or not?
I mean, I'm never going to be able to afford a Porsche, but with that being said, I got a Jetta and a TT in the backyard, and
there you go.
I still got access to all that catalog information.
Shit, and don't you ever say you can never afford a Porsche, all right? You grind hard.
Man, I want to get another house and put my son through college. I don't got my mindset like that. Maybe if that's all done, maybe I'll buy a Porsche when I'm in my 50s.
Fuck putting your son through college. Make him put himself through college. He'll appreciate that shit.
Everybody I know whose parents put him
through college, they just turned out to be spoiled brats that hate their fucking parents. So there it is.
That's
advice from Judy. But I understand you want to make sure that he's on the right foot, but you don't have to walk through the struggle we have to do, you know? Do whatever you need to do. All right, let's go. 888-742-3345.
Let's go to Nicole in Kansas City.
Nicole in Kansas City.
Hello. Oh, my goodness. I'm so excited.
I'm so excited, too.
I'm grateful.
My hand is. What's that?
I hope it's on your pants.
Yep. I'm jerking off right now talking to you.
Perfect. Well, I'm excited that I've made it an entire year breastfeeding my son.
How old is your son? 37.
He is a 1 year old today.
Oh, you made it 1 year breastfeeding your kid? That's good. It helps with bonding with the child. It's better for nutrition and it increases the IQ of the child. So I am a big proponent for breastfeeding.
Yes.
So and congratulations. How much longer are you going to breastfeed for?
Normally something that's, I think we're done. I'd like to have my boobs back for fun.
Are you
stuff,
weaning?
You know?
You're starting the weaning process right now?
Yes.
Okay. Well, congratulations for breastfeeding for that full year. And
thank you.
How are your titties holding up? How are they looking after a year of a kid sucking on them?
Well... Not quite as perky as they used to be, but my nipples are always hard now, so that's maybe a turn on, right? Hey. Yeah.
That helped me come just then. I hate that John had to see that on our Zoom meeting, but these are the things that
doing my part.
Thank you for doing
just
your
doing
part,
my part
with your hard-ass nipples. What's your son's name? I just want to know.
His name is Carter.
Come on, Carter. Suck these titties, Carter. Suck these titties. Yes, is that Carter just, in the background?
That is. Yes, it is.
Carter, you titty sucking motherfucker. Well, congrats on getting your titties back.
Thank you. And my husband would much appreciate it.
Yep, and them not being totally ruined. And the other thing is I'm always shitting on, like, tit surgery. Because I'm like, ah, man, you know, be happy with what God gave you. But I feel like if someone comes in and ruins your tits, you're allowed to fix them. That's my rule on tit surgery. I like a nice flat-chested girl. I think it's fucking sexy. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. What up, though?
Daniel in Virginia.
Daniel in Virginia, what up?
What's up, man? I'm thankful for the stock market, man. It's been popping this past few weeks. GME went burr. I got out before Robinhood was able to rob me like it robbed everyone else. Those crooked fucks. Fuck yeah, Wall Street.
They got me. I'll talk about a little bit on on air, but yeah, some hoe ass shit. Congrats.
Yeah, man. It's fucking insane, man. I've only been trading for a year. I'm up like about 70% of my portfolio. Blessed, man.
Damn, 70%.
Yeah, man. If you got in March and the right things, I caught Netflix right in March, right as the lockdown started. And that boosted me up. I made like $7,000 off Netflix and then rolled into Tesla, Apple, right before the split. Like, just reading and nerding out, man. They're going to lock me down. I'm going to find a way to make this unemployment money work for me.
Fucking awesome. That is awesome. Yeah. Congrats.
Yeah, man. Bless up. Have a good day.
Yep. Straight up. Peace. Hey, today, 7:40. Hey, put on RIP to MF Doom. Put on KMD Peach Fuzz.
Nice, I'm smoother than that, man. I mean, where's Susan? I
know, right?
He was
It's just the thought.
Happy to y'all. The girls, they love me. They love me. I just know it.
You're positive, kid. He's dip, dabbing on the show.
Yeah, how well, yo? He might keep the girls jiggling, yo. I'm the man. Matter of fact, yo, see, they're not gonna do it, yo.
Man,
look at the loose
way.
No, well, anyway. On the hills of my chinny chin chin, got many plus plenty. String by string, I think I count like 20. If you loan me an ear, I'm returning with interest. If not, I'll simply twist your wrist. So listen up closely with thoughts to recoup me. Cause I hope to gross like 10 cents per groupie. Not only if I had 2 G's per strand, ask my anchor banker. He understands I used to wrap my hand around a cold gold can. Someone once said help as well. So check up, I got some perfect checkup. Except for a hiccup, but with no stick up. How can I keep the Goya nectars on myself? Oh boy, how I search for an employer. Bumpy Fuzzy Yellow Huckleberry Finn was in Tom Sawyer. Now use your imagination, just a smidgen. If I was a bird, I'd be a pigeon. Sick of Wonder Crumbs and pizza crust. When I be felican, eat fresh fish and live fat like a pelican. Then again, that's only if you're capable for freckles or blue eyes. I settle for heckle or jekyll while I chuckle at my man with the cellular phone. The only phone I own's a fucky xylophone's tone. Ain't no joy in annoying high pitch ringing. We do the tap twist and twist bringing through soul and this cordless thingamajig. Sure, some rocks, clippers, etch and cling to your weight. We'll do the gig to make your mind thumb twiddlers. The pipe, the bowl of us fillers. Don't riddle us, I'll even ride a bus to the coast if clear. For okay pay, I say I'm finished up, I've been. Now all this running around's kicking me right in the rear. And still I'm judged by the hairs on my chinny chin chin. And I'm able to hit the skin, just like my man Pooba Maxwell. So I'm smooth.
And yeah, can he get the job done with Joe? I take care of business.
Now, what's up with this peach fuzz?
It's on the
what are y'all talking about this peach fuzz?
I got one thing to say.
Peach fuzz. By the hairs of my chinny chin chin, since black hairs, string by string, I think I counts 5 pairs. That's a little, but still, can I get a thumbs up? At least for the peach fuzz, it sums up. A tidbit, yeah, that tipper who gives a sugar honey iced tea besides me. For if I ever rip, getting still, they be sitting with me, so I take time just to kill. I say cutest for a bear, teddy bear like Teddy Ruxpin. Would I be handsome if I pimped in a Tuxedo? Smoked a cigar with some black shiny shoes and picked up some friends in my Benz and start cruising. But that's a dream that I ain't even living in. If that makes a man, surely I recommend I stay a toy boy eating Butterfingers. But now the soft and coloring books on my shelf. I wanna grow up, cause maybe if I did then I wouldn't be treated like a Toys R Us kid when they count 10 up on my chin. By the hands of my peach fuzz, let's say peach was an inch. Psych, because I can't pull a pinch, it's a wrench, and I thought life would be a cinch. But anyhow, let's talk about some way, somehow, how to make my peach fuzz grow up. Really, do I need a beard that goes with no pores just to be respected and resemble Santa Claus? Hear this clear, I'm a man, I tell you. No dreams or drugs like the slugs will I ever sell you. A man I am in the body of a youth, so don't play me like I'm born universe, truth, truth. So when I knock at your hearts, let me in and judge me not by the hairs of my chinny chin chin.
Feel Good Friday. Went back on y'all cats with that shit. Call me up right now. Let me know what you're feeling good for. That is the key to happiness. 888-742-3345. Who we got?
Marcel in Midland, Texas.
Marcel, what up, though?
What up, Jude? How you feeling, man? How's the house?
House is fucking cool. I really haven't been able to enjoy it since I've been sick, but I'm happy to have a spot.
Hey man, I'm glad there ain't no more remixes on, man. But I'm glad, you know, I'm quitting my job today. I'm about to drop this company truck off, man, and I'll start my other job tomorrow, man.
Nice. Don't burn any bridges, cause you never know if you're gonna have to cross some bitches again. And congrats on your new job. What are you gonna be
doing? Man, it's I'm in the oil field, man. It's a little bit different out here, man. Whenever you tell them you give a 2 week, you know, you try to go in and be responsible, give a 2 week notice. Whenever you do that shit, they just let you go right then. So.
Oh yeah.
It's just one of them things. I'm just like, all right, I'm out.
Serious the same way. Serious, give Serious a 2 week notice. They'll put you on your motherfucking ass. They ain't gonna have you on the air fucking reckless and shit with 2 weeks to go. Like,
exactly,
nah,
exactly. That's how it is out here.
Yeah. Not
exactly. They'll be like, I'm happy to accept your resignation right now. So I'm just, yeah, man, I'm about to do, because right now they got me with a shitty schedule. They don't want to change it. And I'm in Phoenix. So me trying to get back home is impossible. So this new job, I got 10 days off. I worked 20 days on. So it was like a no-brainer for me.
Get that bread, dog. Get that bread. 888-742-3345. Yeah. Shout out to everybody out there in the oil fields. We got a gang of cats that listen to us in the oil fields, to be real with you. Who we got?
Anthony in Toronto.
Yo, Ant, what's up?
Hey, man. It's going good, man. It's going good. I'm feeling good today. I'm almost 5 months sober. I've been battling addiction for the last 4 years of my life, but finally got everything on track, and I'm feeling good. I'm feeling healthy.
What were you addicted to?
I was addicted to Oxycontins, Percocets, any painkiller, really.
I got the plug on Oxy 30s for 10, bro. So just let me, I'm playing with you. I wouldn't do you like that.
No, I got my boys hit me up. They're like, yo, I'm about the 80s crush. She's back on deck. And I'm like, man, you know, I'd love to go down that road again, but I've been there too many times. And I don't mean how much hardship and how much people you can hurt doing that stuff. So just keep yourself focused, grounded, and just keep striving to do better.
Yeah, straight up. I don't know. Like, I got two books that touch on addiction. So, trust me, I know. So, congrats on that shit. It ain't easy to kick that type of shit. So, congrats to you. 888-742-3345. Who we got?
CJ in Fresno.
CJ, what up, though?
What's up with it, man?
You got it. What are you feeling good about?
Man, Rude Jude, man, what's up with it, dog? Hey, man, I'm grateful for, you know, I'm trying to make some moves and everything. I made a move. You know, I got inheritance, and then put a pool in my backyard and everything else for the fam. All so, right. You know, this summer, man, it's gonna be popping. You know, so
You added to the value of your house too. Congratulations.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You know, and you keep the family happy, man. You know, with this COVID stuff going on, everybody at home, nowhere to go. You know, hey, the oasis is in the backyard. You know what I'm saying?
Trust. I'm looking at a fucking lake. It's frozen, but if they keep that shit locked down, I'm gonna be out in that bitch frolicking in the waves and shit. I'm gonna learn how to ice skate. I already know how to ice skate. I feel you, bro. You got to find happiness within your own little circle, because They be trying to lock shit down.
You got to, man. You got to. That's what it's all about, you know, keeping the family happy, you know, counting the blessings and everything else, you know. That's what's up, though, man.
Hell yeah.
But this summer, though, you know, in Fresno, man, you know, you live in Cali, right? You L.A., right? I know you're in Michigan or something.
I left,
like that,
bro. I was out there for 20 years. So I already know. So that's good shit. You got a crib and you got a family. That ain't easy to do in California. So I'm tip my hat to you. Who we got?
Gina in Charlotte.
Gina.
Hey, what's up? I'm so excited to be talking to you. I'm feeling good for I'm feeling good for my breast lift that I got.
You got a breast lift? We were just talking about that shit.
Yeah.
Tell me about your titties.
I know.
Let's talk about your tits.
So I want to call you every Friday, but I never know what I want to talk about or what I feel good about. I listen to your show every Friday. Well, actually every day when I get off.
Nice.
And I heard you talking shit about breast lifts, and I'm like, this is my chance to call.
So you had a kid breastfed, and that little motherfucker stole titties from you? That titty stealing little fucker?
No, I didn't breastfeed. I did that shit for about 3 weeks. That was not my thing.
So wait, why are you getting a breast lift then?
Well, so I did have a kid, and I mean, your breast sag, even when you're
really?
Pregnant and you have a baby.
Wow, yeah. I didn't know that. I thought it was from fucking breastfeeding, but you could be a fucking a bad mom like you and not even breastfeed and still need a breast.
Yeah, you can just be shitty.
You can just be a shitty mom and still need a breast lift. That's crazy.
Right.
Wow. Did you get it, or are you about to?
No, I got it done. It's been about 8 weeks, and I was cleared to, do whatever I want. So I'm buying bathing suits, getting ready for the summer. I'm excited.
titties feeling like they're 17 again. Yeah, look at you, fucking. Titties about to go to prom. Titties about to go to prom. Congrats on your fucking new lease on tits. Let's keep this shit going. 888-742. You're welcome. It's Feel Good Friday.
Got
John.
Sophia in the Bay Area.
Sophia in the Bay. What up?
Hey, dude. I'm feeling good today because I think this asshole's finally going to pay me my money back.
What'd you loan him money for?
So we've been friends for like a good 5 years. He just got out of jail. He needed some help. Like his fucking dog had to get his teeth pulled, all this shit. He needs some help. We've been friends for forever. I lent him some money. He's ducking me for like 20 days, not responding, coming up with bullshit, posting weed on his story off my dime, you know. So I finally kind of lost it. I requested money from him on like everything and just, you know, I started pressing him. And then he finally was like, you know what? Like $800, which isn't a lot, but it's like you're my friend.
No, it is a lot. $800 is $800. You got it.
That's what I'm saying.
What did you learn from this?
I learned not to loan anybody money. And he's all like, oh, you think that measly $800 is going to save your life? Like, bitch, you're tripping. You're pressing me over $800. And I'm like, if it's so little, then give it to me. So
yeah, it's not about the amount. It's the principle of it.
Principle. Exactly.
And,
exactly.
All right. Look. So, when you getting your money back?
Should be soon. He told me gave me his friend's information. He's like gonna do jail, whatever. So it should be today.
Good.
But it's still fucked up.
And then you guys aren't friends no more. He lost a friend.
No, he called me bitch. He called me fucking crazy white bitch. All this shit. So I'm over it.
Yeah. No. Look, man. Don't do it. It's funny, my shit happened with $40. Same deal, my homeboy just got out of jail. I hook him up with, like, you know, he did an armed robbery, so I'm like, and he went away for a few years, so I'm like, I give him a sharing. I got him in Nautica. This was back in the 90s and shit. I'm just trying to help him out, and he hit me up for $40 to get a shirt to go on a job interview. And I'm like, I gave you a bunch of Nautica shirts. Where's one of those? He's like, oh, no, I need a different kind of shirt. motherfucker ducked me. And they talk about it in Bronx Tale. There's a couple good like life lessons in Bronx Tale, but that's one of them. That motherfucker, he for $40, I got rid of a fucking piece of shit. He exposed himself to be a fucking asshole, bitch, piece of shit, and I got rid of him for $40. I got off cheap. It could have been a lot worse. 888-742-3345. Don't give nobody shit. Don't give out no loans. Just give them money if you have to.
Got Victor in Arizona.
Victor, what up, though?
What up, man? I'm thankful, man, for being out, man. Two years straight, man. I've been out of prison. I just got out, man. I did a 5-piece straight flat.
Damn, what'd they get you for?
Yeah, man, me and my brother, man, we co-defendants, you know. They didn't want me to. I can't tell them, my brother, so I had to do the time, you know. So I did
what'd
the time,
get,
5 years
what'd
straight.
What'd they get you for?
A conspiracy and organized crime. I ain't gonna say the rest. You know what I'm saying? Right. I ain't gonna dig in too deep, but it was some deep shit, man. I was making millions, man, millions. But you know what? I had to do it for my kids, man. I had to change my life. I had to reestablish myself, man. And my older brother, he put me in the right spot, man. He gave me the perfect job, man, a career setting job.
What about all that money? Did it just disappear?
Man, you know what? It doesn't matter, man. It doesn't even matter anymore, man, because it ain't even worth it. Losing the life. Losing time out of my kid's life, it's not worth it, man. It ain't worth it.
I understand. I'm just kind of curious to see. You looked out for your bro and all that shit, and then I just want to see if
you
looked out
back. Let's just say this. $2.5 million was lost. Let's just say that. That's all I'm going to say. $2.5 million. And I cried for a month straight, but it's all right, man. It's
damn,
shit that don't matter, man.
Million.
People need to understand. People got to understand, man, that it can take away the most valuable thing in your life, man, and that's your children. If they don't care about their children, they don't care about their life, man. And that's why I'm grateful now, because I get to come home every day to my kids, and I get to pay, and I get to make legit money, and I get to say, you know what, I worked hard for that.
Yeah. No, you're right on everything.
It's hard, man.
The only thing I gotta disagree with you about is if you don't want to have a fucking kid and some chick has a kid, it's different. It's just different.
Oh, yeah,
When you and somebody plan to have a baby together, that's you're making something together. The other way, it's like they throwing some shit on you. I'm not sticking up for deadbeat dads. I'm just saying that shit is a little bit different that way. But congrats that you got it. I'm happy that you made some kids that you actually wanted.
Yeah, it did some damage, man. It did some damage. But like I said, man, I was able to rehabilitate myself and realize, man, what's more valuable. You know, family, my kids, man. I gotta do it better for me. Not only for my kids, but I gotta do it for myself. Do it for myself and better myself. And if I can show others that I can do it, they can do it too.
How many burpees can you do?
I do 113, baby. California boy, we do 113 every day, 6 in the morning.
Hitting them burpees like a motherfucker.
They can't fuck with us. They can't fuck with us. They know that. Workout plan, we break people off, man. That's what we do.
They won't even
be able to wipe their ass by the time I get done with them.
I'm telling you, they don't play. They don't play.
What it is, man. You know what it is, Jude.
Yeah, I'm just. You was California, so which? What was you locked? What was you locked up with? Who's you with?
Well, you know what I'm saying, being in Arizona, we got to ride. You know, I'm the.
You AZ?
My bad.
Okay, my bad.
Yeah, I'm in AZ. I did time. I had to do time out here, but it was worse out there, man. It was worse out there. I was out there, you know, doing the most. I could have been dead, and I had to relocate. Fortunately, it took me to come out here to go to prison, and I'm like, shit, it could have been worse. I couldn't be here right now. I wouldn't be talking to you right now if I'd have stayed in Cali.
I know, I'm just asking who I'm asking who you was, like, clicked up with in there.
Sureño, homie. Sureño. Yeah. Hell no. We don't ride with no busters. We Southern.
That's why
we Southern
asking.
Boys.
Yeah, that's why I wanted to know.
We Southern, though. Man, it's possible, man. Just be grateful.
No, it is. It's real talk. Be grateful. See, I didn't know that shit. There's like a weird thing between like the Mexican cats, the Norteños and the Serranos. Did you know that shit, John?
I did not know that. I'm looking it up right now. I always hate talking about that, gangs. Makes me nervous. Serranos.
Whatever. Like, it's, yeah. And I think that's the, yeah, because you go to the California prisons and it's just like you kind of get clicked up. You really ain't got no choice. That's from what I've heard on YouTube. You pretty much ain't got no choice. They're just kind of throwing you wherever the fuck they want you to go.
It looks like they're mixed up with the Mexican mafia. Yikes.
Yeah. And then the Norteños, I think they fuck more with like, I think they're cool with the black gangs, from what my understanding on YouTube.
Yeah, that's what YouTube tells you.
That's what I understand on YouTube. Yeah, I be sitting there just soaking up shit on YouTube. Like, tell me more, YouTube. I had to stop. They kept sending me prison shit.
Yeah.
Who's our prison guy? Larry.
Isn't it Larry Lawton?
Larry Lawton. Larry Lawton's our prison guy. He's our prison dude. He did a 10-year bid in the Fed time for a jewelry robbery for the Gambino family. So he comes on and talks to us a bit. But I found him on YouTube, and so YouTube kept, you know, they do the algorithms. They're sending me all types of prison shit. So I was just sitting back, soaking it up. And shout out to everybody locked up in the Bing right now listening. Keep your head up, baby. Keep your motherfucking head up and keep grinding. Who else we got?
Joe in the Bronx.
Yo, what's good with you, Jude?
You got it. What are you feeling good for?
What I'm feeling good. Well, first of all, you talk about some Bronx Tale shit. So there's a certain actress in the Bronx Tale that might have been married to De Niro in the Bronx Tale. So
I gotta look that up. All right, what about it?
So you can look up the name, De Niro's wife in the Bronx Tale. I've been with her niece in real life for the last 6 years.
Get out of here. She's
trying to get pregnant. I love the girl to death, but I hate her because old bitches are fucking assholes. With that being said, trying to get pregnant. She got her period today, and I've been doing jumping jacks all day.
Wait, you've been fucking with her. You didn't want to get her pregnant, and then...
We went that route, didn't work out too well, and now, you know, since COVID, she turned into the typical, you're like a YouTuber, typical Gambino girl, blah, 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 wants to have a kid. I don't want to have a kid in this world, my dude. I just want to listen to Shake 45, get fucked up all day and enjoy it.
Man, have a kid, bro. Have a kid, ain't
you? Yeah, have a kid. All right, yo, all right, send me that check and I'll have a kid.
Bro, just cut out some money, stop buying dumb shit, and have a fucking kid. That's the only reason why we're here. Like, we like to think that we're like these, we're fucking animals. That's what you're here. You're here to reproduce. Fucking have a goddamn kid. Find some meaning in that shit.
I got 14 kids in 17 countries. Well, I don't want to have another one.
You got 14 kids in 17 countries. What the fuck you do? You were like one of the doctors? Doctors with beyond borders?
Rock stars don't dye their hair, they just die.
My man. All right. I'm looking at Bronx Hill. I can't find it. I can't find any. There's so many goddamn different. Is it Gianna Palmentary's kid or niece?
No. De Niro's wife in the Bronx Hill.
Is that Rosina?
C's mother in the Bronx Tale.
I know, but like AKA, they tell you their fucking names. They don't say C's mother.
All right, okay. So Audie Bucco's wife in the Sopranos.
Getting really complicated here.
This fucking guy. Don't have kids. You're right. Don't. Do not have fucking kids. You're driving me fucking crazy. Imagine his kids. He's a grown up. Imagine the kids he's gonna raise. Fucking pain in the ass. Artie Bucco's wife in the Sopranos. Alright, let's see. Artie Bucco. Damn, that shit came up quick. Artie B. Bucco's wife. Yeah, that's the one I asked. That's what I said. He didn't even know. Oh.
Wait a minute. So he's dating her? She's beautiful. What is
that? No, her niece.
Oh, I got confused with this guy.
She's dating the niece. Oh, okay. She was in, she worked a lot. Artie Bucco was the guy that ran the restaurant for anybody that hasn't binge watched The Sopranos during the COVID lockdown. I feel like half the people I know binge watched, rewatched The Sopranos. I was one of them. And rewatching, I was just like, man, Tony, you a dumb motherfucker. Half the time I was just like, oh, Tony, what are you doing, man? That's all I kept doing was shaking my head for Tony Soprano, like, you fucking idiot. 888-742-3345. Who else we got?
Christine over in Dallas.
Christine in Dallas.
Hi, Jude, on a Friday.
Hey, what's up, girl? What are you feeling good for?
So I got a promotion this month, and nice. I went from making, I would say, 5 figures to 6.
Congratulations. That's a fucking nice jump.
Yes. No college training, no degree, just a promotion because the executive loved me.
And the executive loves you, why?
I guess because of my personality. He's not a dude.
Do you show up on time? Do you show up on time? Do you grind?
All the time.
All right, then. That's why the executive loves you. Because you show up on time, you grind, you probably don't bitch about shit. That's why they fuck with you.
Yes, and I have my own business making cakes. And they've been using me to make cakes for the company for a whole year before I even got the promotion. So it's like a double payment.
You've been caking up. Caking the fuck up, girl. Literally. Good for you. Literally. All right.
I've been on the Food Network, the Cooking Channel, and I'm on Netflix making cakes.
Really? What's your name?
My Instagram is light_bright_delight.
Light, LIGHT?
Yes.
light_bright_delight. I mean, she's everywhere and doesn't want me to give me her fucking name. I'm trying to plug her goddamn cooking, her bacon shit.
My name is Christina English.
Light, bright, the light. It doesn't even come up. Let me see. Instagram.
Oh, yeah. I see her.
She's been everywhere, they say. Christina English, light, bright, the light. Let's see.
Underscore.
Look at you. Go ahead,
words.
Christina. And keep making them cakes.
Yay.
Fuck yeah.
Thank you. Thank you for making me feel good on a Friday.
I ain't do shit. I'm just over here co-signing your loans, girl. But I don't co-sign bullshit loans. So good on you for grinding hard. Those cakes look fucking sweet as hell. And keep getting after it. I love people that get after it. No excuses. Go get it. That's life. All right. And with Fudge Pudge, we done here. Let's go. That was Feel Good Friday. Shout out to Light Bright Delight. She was on television.
Here we go again with a funky intro. People approach me knowing I'm the Prince Pro. E-T-R-Y, yes, and I'm the first batter. The Pharaoh usually go first, but it don't matter. Funky slices of beats like this comes once in a blue, but it's not hard for me to chew. So kick off your shoes and don't forget your socks. I wash and wash them MCs like Clorox. Skills I have good and plenty. If you want dope lyrics plus ill gimmicks, give me beats equivalent to this, something that I can float, low, float, low, float on. It's getting breezy, take it easy, keep the cord on. When I proceed to light the party in the summer, something like a Mardi Gras. Bikinis, panties, bras, juicing them and I'm sucking the girls out like straws. Oops, upside your dome. I don't answer the phone when I'm home, not alone, on the bone.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Hey, y'all, you are listening to the All Out Show. If you want to, it's Friday, right? Blow some money. Go to onemorejude.com and grab yourself some All Out Show gear. If you didn't get any of your gear, go back to that site and hit them up. I'm saying that because somebody didn't get a shirt or something like that. So if you didn't get your shirt, hit them up. Don't hit me up. I don't know what to do. I'm stupid. But I'm smart enough to fucking shill some shit to you guys. Go to onemorejude.com. You can even hear the Howard Stern interview on there. The legendary. I'm going to be real with you. It's one of the best interviews on Stern. My interview is one of the best interviews Stern ever did. Fucking Rude Jude, Howard Stern sitting down chopping it up. 45 minutes. One of the best interviews ever done. Go to One More Jude. Way better than Richard Nixon and that one dude. Go to onemorejude.com. Also follow the All Out Show at All Out Show on everything. And check this out. I also do mixes. And I like to keep track of people because you never know what's going to happen. So hit me up at 213-205-3747. Sign up for community. And you can be on my texting list. I don't text that much. I sent out some mixes that Keenan had hooked up for me. So there. So fucking there. Whoopty fucking do, let's go. It's an All Out Show.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John C. Matthews.
Shape Magazine, they are telling us that we should be using finger condoms.
What?
Finger condoms. Those little finger cots you see on people.
Are you fucking kidding me, man?
They're looking out for you.
Fuck Shape. What good is finger fucking a girl if you can't feel that wet pussy?
Well, they're worried you're gonna give her your
that motherfucking that wet ass monkey.
Well, I guess it'd be slippery.
Gouging that shit out, you know what I'm saying? What's the purpose? I don't even like to wear gloves when I shovel snow. What the fuck? I'm gonna put on a fucking finger condom.
You want to feel your environment?
I want to feel that shit, man. I want to feel it. I want to feel that wet ass snatch. And here, hey, before you finger fuck a girl, especially if you're at the, I get it, if you're out and about, I understand. If you're at the crib, get up, go wash your hands. That's it. Just wash your hands and then finger fuck her. And guess what? It's a lost art, finger fucking. Most of you guys don't know how to finger fuck.
Well, you've got that scrape technique that you've taught me over the years.
Man, my finger fucking game is on point. I finger fuck like a lesbian.
How did you develop this skill?
Look, when you can't slam dunk, you gotta develop a jump shot. My dick ain't a bat, so I had to develop all these other techniques.
Well, they are saying that there's a chance these finger cots can help with pleasure. If, let's say, your hands are rough or dry, maybe if you got to clip your nails, you can put on your finger cot and not worry about that.
I understand that, John. I get it, but if you're finger fucking a girl with an open hand wound, like, come on, like that. This is basically what this goddamn article was for people who finger fuck women with open hand wounds. That's what it's come to.
That's
what you open with.
You don't want to do that.
Fuck! I just got. I get bad. I've been gone for 2 weeks. You open with this shit.
It's a public
you
service.
Fucking asshole. Man, give me something different. What a dick.
All right, so last week, even though you were out of commission, I don't know how you could have avoided this whole GameStop experience.
Dude, I got fucked on that.
What?
Because it wasn't just GameStop. It was a bunch of different ones that
sure.
they were doing, and I bought Express. Because look, they got a good point. It's like these people, they fucking fuck with the stocks all the goddamn time. They manipulate stocks all the time. How come people can't manipulate stocks? So my man told me Express was about to go, so I went, and then I got sick and I woke up and I wasn't keeping track. And by the next day I had lost like a couple thousand dollars.
Oh.
Off that Express shit, yeah. Off them stopping the Express, that you couldn't, they made it where you couldn't buy it. That's like illegal, bro. Like,
well, I don't know if it's illegal.
If you really want to, like, if you really want to see who's running shit, there you go. Wall Street bankers, that's who's running shit, because they do the exact same thing all the fucking time. They'll get a company, they'll fucking short it, they'll run it into the ground, they'll ruin people's lives. And when the common dude, and we had a Feel Good Friday a couple weeks ago of a dude talking about this. He made money off of this. He was like, I'm on stock, whatever, chats on Reddit. He called up on Feel Good Friday, said he caked up off of this. And I didn't put two and two together. My man called me up. He was like, hop on this. I did. I was doing good for a second. Went down and then came to and was just like, oh my God, like what the fuck happened? And they literally stopped trading. They stopped trading on the stock, bro. Now one can argue that, yeah, they do that so that they can't manipulate the stocks, but like what the fuck do you think hedge funds have been doing?
Sure, they go
all
on.
All they do is manipulate stocks. This is bullshit, bro.
They go on CNBC, do a quick interview. Oh, look at that little spike over there. Maybe now they hit Twitter. Elon's been known to do that.
You already know that shit, man. They're always manipulating these fucking stocks. And that's on the board, on the up and up, going on CNBC and shit like that. That's not even like the low key shit. So the minute that we try to strike back and get some money of our own, they shut that shit down. Wall Street and fucking shit. The people who run Wall Street run America. They showed you that shit. And I got bit. I was like, damn, they got me. Well,
did that hurt when you lose that kind of money? I mean, it's not a huge amount, but still, is that, you wake up like, God damn it.
Yeah, dude, I just bought a house. Yeah. I had to sink all this money into this fucking house. I was liquid to do shit, and it took, like, I was trying to come out with some eyeglass frames, and, like, now I can't come out with the eyeglass frames right now because they decided that they wanted to freeze the stock. So for people that aren't paying attention, the people on the internet got together. They said, we're going to go with this stock, and this stock, and we're going to buy a bunch of it, run up the price. And that stock manipulation, correct?
Yes.
But how is it any different than being like, this is a really good product? This is like, they do the same shit. That's what I'm saying, man. They just call it something different.
Yeah, it's one of those things where it was just a fluke, and these smart guys, one is now under investigation, sort of the main guy ahead of all, like who is behind a lot of the run here. But he worked in that industry and recently dropped out of that, but he's got some problems coming. And get this. So he held onto the stock for quite some time. He made millions of dollars. And then on Tuesday of this week, he lost like $13 million. I mean...
Yeah.
I mean, it's
all on paper, but like
I know, but still, it's like, dude, sell. I mean,
I don't know why he didn't sell. Well, yeah, I was like, I asked my man, I was like, is it done? Because I thought that they had like, I thought they proved their point and like the shit started dropping. I was like, it's over. He was like, nah, bro, the fucking stock market made it where you couldn't buy the stock. That's some hoe ass shit. That's like me going to a store saying that I want to buy this and you saying you can't buy that. You can buy all these other things, but this is off limits because wacky shit's going on.
Oh, sure.
For all you people that got bankers' backs, fuck you. Fuck you.
And really, it's probably more complicated than we even understand. So some of these large hedge funds, they're also making money off of all these crazy transactions on Robinhood. So it's just like, well, yeah, how did all this start?
They're using Robinhood to see, they're using Robinhood to see all Robinhood is doing is collecting data for these fucking, these giant hedge funds, and then they sell them the fucking data. And then they do whatever they want with that data. I got homies that have been in hedge funds where they, he's saved companies and he's literally bought a company and fucking ran that bitch into the ground and deaded a whole bunch of people's jobs. I didn't see that happen over here. They weren't shorting people. They were shorting. They were making fucking billionaires lose money. They weren't killing the little man. The little man was trying to fight back, and what did they do? They fucking stepped on. They stepped on our neck.
Now, one could argue there is some benefit to short selling, and this does make sense. So, you know, if some company is overvalued, then these people come in and they say, you know what, this company's not doing so well. I mean, all you have to do is look like...
Yeah, but that can be manipulated. Just yes. It can be manipulated. It's right. A fucking problem. That's the problem. Like, it can all be manipulated. So, like, fuck you.
Oh, but
I'm with Wall Street Bets, dog, all day. Wall Street Bets. I'm rocking with y'all cats. I'm rocking with the little man. That's who I'm rocking with.
Did you actually join? I did. Are you in Wall Street Bets?
I don't even know how to get on any of that shit on Reddit, bro. Like, I don't know if you know. I haven't been able to do shit lately. I've been fucked.
That had to occur to me. All right. So back to Elon for a second. But this is a good thing. So he asked this question at every interview to spot a liar. And
what? Ask me the question, and then we can tell if I'm a liar or not.
All right. So can you describe a problem that you faced and how you solved it?
Huh. Jesus Christ. Fuck. I had a drug addiction, and I...
This is a job interview.
Oh. They'd be like, thank you.
Thanks for coming. There.
Okay. Hey, Elon, I got a really bad drug addiction, but I got a good heart. I'm a really hard worker. Let's see. A problem? Can I... Honestly, I'd be like, sometimes it's hard for me to work with people, but I just shut the fuck up and I just keep doing what I feel like I need to do.
Yeah, I think that works.
To keep things going, because ultimately what's good for the company is good for me, because that's what's paying me. That would be my answer.
I think it's a good one. You rise above it and you look towards the greater good.
What's the bad answer?
Well, the bad answer is that you're in there saying, "Yeah, I'm a great producer," and like, okay, what did you do to become a great producer? You don't really have an answer because you don't even know what the problems are.
That's what you did to me.
I did not.
You didn't even know the problems. He didn't even know the problems.
I do know the problems. I've faced so many.
I know the show. I listen to the show all the time. Never heard it.
Not true.
Never heard the show ever. Just heard fucking pre-taping interviews with people, never heard the show. I'm like, oh, we're gonna run this. You're like, what's that? I'm like, I don't know. It's a weekly fucking segment that we've been doing for the last 10 fucking years. You know the goddamn show, you lying motherfucker.
You make it sound like I'm brain dead.
Where's Elon Musk? I needed Elon in that goddamn job interview. Keenan was good. Mm-hmm. He ain't lie.
No.
Keenan kept that shit 100.
He's a good man.
Mm-hmm.
So you won't like this, but there's another option for fertility and how to prevent a woman from getting pregnant. So they're calling it the sperm switch.
Hey, again, all right.
It would allow men to
talk to me.
It would allow men to turn their fertility off. But
how?
Well, because they've identified this molecule. It's a switch, and so sperm, as you may know, they're out there fighting and killing other sperm trying to get to the egg. And yeah. Then also they're more...
We start straight up Darwin. Just remember that. All you little pussies are like, oh, look out for the best person, this, that, and the third. the strongest sperm got to you. Just remember that. There was some bitch ass sperm that didn't make it and shouldn't have.
All right,
keep going.
All right, and so sperm with this protein, they even move faster than their peers, establishing an advantage to who reaches the egg first. So the idea is,
what am I to do? You didn't have a retarded baby? Is that what you're trying to tell me? You're gonna give me the slow sperm's gonna win?
That is the idea that you would.
That's the dumbest idea I've ever heard.
Well, it would prevent the sperm from reaching the egg, so then...
How do you know? What if some slow-ass sperm, just fucking got to the goddamn egg? Now I got fucking weak baby.
That's not impossible.
I'm in the corner with weak baby. Like, hey, this is Oliver. He's my weak baby. He's allergic to everything.
It's a work in progress.
That's fucking ridiculous, dude. This is the stupidest. That one's dumb. I thought it was a real talk. I'm going to be real with you. I thought they surgically implanted a switch and you could just hit a button and it would make it where you were shooting blanks. I was like, for it.
Well, I suppose.
I would have been for that.
Theoretically, you could have a patch on and release this chemical in your body. Who knows? We'll see.
I don't want a chemical patch. I want a mechanical patch that fucking stops the fucking... Stops it. That's like a little dam that I hit a button next to my thigh. It goes, stops that shit. I could fuck raw, bust a nut, hit the button, and leak it out into the fucking toilet like a man. Like a fucking man.
Sounds sexy.
That's how I get the chicks, bro. Saying sexy shit like that. That's the worst idea ever. Only the strong.
I mean, these are scientists who are trying to come up with a novel way of...
Stupid.
Okay. But again, there's...
Just because you can do it doesn't mean you should do it.
Well, they are.
That's like one of those like sci-fi shits. It's like, should you be doing this? Should we be making it where the weakest fucking sperm is getting to the egg? Has a better chance to get to the egg? Look at us already with our conditioning. We already turned into a bunch of fucking bitches. Now you're gonna make it where some bitch ass sperm is gonna fertilize the egg? You crazy?
Well. Again, just finally, it could work the other way too. So you could have it so if you're rocking those weak sperm, you could give them a jolt and then they would become really aggressive and fast.
Super sperm?
Yep. So it works both ways.
I was talking, I was on acid and I was talking to this woman and I was like, look, the next step is we're going to become robots. That's it. It's over. It's done. Think about this shit.
Bionic Jude.
Whoever gets the technology to be a superhuman is going to use that technology. And then they're going to use that technology to dominate the people that aren't.
Yeah.
So it's over. Like, it's done. Your grandkids aren't going to be human. Not the way we are. I mean, you see people that are two generations below us. They're barely fucking human. It's done. We're going to have little fucking robots running all around this bitch.
Something weird's going to happen. I don't think we'll be around to see it, but it'll happen slowly, then all at once.
Bang. I don't know, dude. Technology is growing exponentially. If you would have told me this shit that's happening 20 years ago is happening right now, I would not have believed you. Not in the least bit.
It is kind of hard to believe. The first time I sat down in front of the internet, now it's everywhere. It's in my pocket.
It's just the internet. You're constantly being marketed to. You're constantly being tracked. All of that shit. 20 years ago, you've been like, shut the fuck up. Not even a chance. And then you got people that are 20 years old. That's all they know.
Oh, sure. I remember years ago, you said something to me that really stuck with me. You said, you know, even when you leave your phone at home, now you go back and get your tracking device and bring it with you. I mean, that's literally what you're doing when you forget your phone. Oh, let me get my tracking device before I leave for work.
Let me get this shit that so the feds can eavesdrop on me. I stand by my whole signal thing. I think it's ran by the feds, honestly, real talk.
Mm-hmm.
I think signal is working with the feds.
Are you on signal?
Yeah, because some drug dealers want to use it, and I got to fucking use Signal, and I'm like, ugh, what the fuck, dude? I got to use fucking Signal just to buy drugs? Like, who do you think came up with this technology? Who do you think they're working with?
I always think less than...
Who's Apple working with? Who's fucking Facebook working with? Who's Google working with? They're all working with the fucking government and all that shit. You think they're just going to let that shit slide on so that you can fucking buy your little fucking drugs low-key? Yeah, right. It's a wrap, son. Excuse me.
Huh? All right, so do you know why weed gives you the munchies? Why you get hungry?
Because when I smoked weed, I was a fat fuck. A fat piece of shit. Is that why?
Well, THC. It's the most psychoactive component in cannabis, and it is the ultimate cause of the munchies. But Yeah.
So maybe I wasn't always. No, I am a fat. I'm deep down inside, I'm a fat fuck. I'm a fat kid deep down inside.
Mentally, you're still carrying that burden?
Yeah.
Really?
I'll eat my feelings. I ain't gonna bullshit you. Some shit happens. Sit down. Just fucking eat my fucking feelings thinking about that shit. Like, how?
You get a pizza or what?
Do I get a pizza?
I don't know. What do you eat?
Whatever the fuck is in the fridge. I eat it. When I'm sad or when I'm mad. You've had me eating a bunch of shit a gang of times, John. Just know that. You've made me eat my feelings so many fucking times, dog.
Fucking John.
So many calories I've ingested because of your fucking ass.
Where's my burger? Ease the pain.
Straight up. You use drugs. I use drugs and food. I've curbed it a bit. I used to be 240.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've heard that from our mutual friend Patrick, who knew you back in the day. He said, yeah, Jude was kind of big. Kind of a big kid.
Kinda. All right, go ahead. What else?
All right. So briefly, they are saying if you do have the munchies, don't order that pizza. Unlike you, you should go and eat your, have a banana, get some apples.
Have a banana and get some apples?
Well, they're just saying the
okay,
problem is
sure.
People want fat and stuff like that. All right, but I do have some good news. I'm not sure I sent this to you yet, but let me see.
Lay it on me, champ.
And now, time for good news.
All right, hey. Let me send this your way so you can witness this joyous moment. But it's gaining some attention. There is a janitor who, a custodian, whatever you want to call him these days. He is with the...
I'll call him the fucking janitor.
The
I'm tired of people. They change the names and then they cut your wages. They're like, congratulations, you're a custodian. You're no longer a janitor, but here's this pay cut. Take that. Sit on that. You can't pay your rent, custodian. Don't you feel better about yourself?
Well, he is a longtime Liberty Benton Middle School custodian, Joe Orions, and he was just out cleaning up the gym, picked up the ball, and then did a no-look-backwards half-court shot, sank it, and then the principal, he saw the security footage and posted it, and it's getting some attention. So if you hit play
cool.
in there, you can see it. And the guy's living his life.
I'm going to watch it.
All right.
Let's check out this fucking janitor. It made it to TMZ.
Yep. Bang.
Let's see. Let's see him do it. All right, come on. Security, school security cam catches custodian. See, even they call them custodians. They call them custodians instead of janitors and cut their wages. Congratulations.
The custodial arts.
Threw it up. Blam.
Raises his arms in victory.
Just he already knew it.
Goes about
he
his
already
day.
Knew it, and he took his vacuum and fucking walked his ass, walked his custodial engineer ass to go clean a fucking toilet for less wages than he got
Mighty
30
Joe.
Years ago. Congratulations.
Over in Ohio. Joe in Ohio.
Araka. Araka, 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 araka. He looks like he ain't miss a meal. Maybe he eats his feelings too.
He seems happy. He's sank that shot.
Yeah, he sank the fuck out of that shot.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the news.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, y'all, that was the show. I want to thank everybody for calling. Special thanks to Shanice for coming in and helping out on the show from Philly. Rapping, well, she's not from Philly, but she's there now, so there you go. Keenan and John both been running the show since I've been gone, and I want to thank everybody for calling up, all the well wishes, everything like that. So I will be back on Monday. God damn it, let's go.